Hello everyone, I am your chef Rupa. Today I have come up with very interesting recipe, which I guess everybody likes to eat. That's nothing but our chicken biryani. Cooking chicken biryani is not a rocket science. It's very easy. It's a little bit of time taking, but it's worth it. Usually, cooking chicken biryani doesn't take much time. It requires only preparation time. If all the things are ready, it's very easy to cook. So today I'm going to cook it with easily available ingredient at home in my kitchen. So let's get started. Here I have taken one bowl of marinated chicken. For marination, you can check out my previous video of chicken ghee roast. The same marination I have followed here. Now let's begin with the process. Here I have taken one handi. I have kept the flame on high. Since we are going to make biryani, we'll use this handi. Now the handi is preheated. I am going to add 2 tablespoons of ghee in it. Now let it get heated. And I am going to add the all dry spices inside the handi. Let me saute. Here I have taken one medium sized onion, finely chopped. I am going to add that inside it. Now we'll saute the onion until it becomes softer and translucent. Till my onions are getting fried. For the rice, I have already kept water for boiling. The water is boiled. Here, I have kept 1 cup of basmati rice, which is washed well and soaked for about 15 minutes. Inside water, I am going to add a very little bit of ghee and 2 cloves, cardamom and some green chilies inside this. I am doing this so that by doing this, rice will have a very nice flavor. Onions are fried well and you can see the color is very translucent. At this stage, I am going to add 1 full tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. I am not adding much because in marination also, I have added it. Now, I have sauteed the ginger garlic paste well. Now, I have 2 medium sized tomato finely chopped. I am going to put it inside this and saute. Adding salt as per requirement, as per your taste. 1 small spoon of turmeric. Chili I am adding 2 teaspoons because if it is spicy, it tastes well. 2 tablespoons of coriander powder. 1 mini tablespoon of garam masala. And here, 1 full tablespoon of biryani masala. And now, saute this mixture well. Now, keep the volume very low and let this mixture get fried on its own. We'll fry it for another 5 minutes. We can see the water has boiled well. At this stage, I am going to add the soaked rice. As I said, I have already soaked it for past 15 minutes. Now I am going to put it inside the water. I'll just take a little water from here. Mix it well and let it cook. Now as we can see, all the mixture have got mixed well. Now I am going to add few green chilies in it and few kadi pattas. That is my extra addition. If you want, you can skip it. Now the marinated chicken, I am going to put it inside it and mixing well. Thank you. Now I am gonna cover it. Now I'm gonna cover it with the lid and it will cook for another 5 minutes on low flame. As we can see, the chicken is cooked now, half cooked now. At this stage, I'm going to start the layering. For that, I'll just put off the burner and we'll start layering. So let's get started. Now, as I said, we are going to start the layering. So chicken is at the base. On top of that, I'm just gonna spread half of the rice. Nicely cover it. On top of it, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of ghee. Biryani is all about flavors, so don't hesitate in adding ghee. Some fried onions. I have already fried onions and kept it before. Little bit of pudina and dhania followed. Now again we are going to make another layer. For that, again put remaining rice. I'll just spread it roughly. Spread it nicely. Again add 1 tablespoon of ghee in it. Remaining fried onions on the top. Pudina. Coriander leaves. Pudina is also called as mint leaves for your reference. Now, here I have taken some orange color essence which I am going to spread it all over the rice. Around half cup of milk. Inside the milk I have added saffron. If you don't have, you can skip that part. I am not adding kevra or rose water here as we don't like that taste much. Now, here the rice in which water I have boiled rice, the same water I am going to put it inside the biryani. Very little. Around half cup. Well, that looks very tempting and yummy. Now I'm going to put it for dum. So before putting it for dum, you can apply this binded wheat flour. I already had it, so I'm using it now. You're gonna put it up. So as we can see that I have added this binded flour all over here so that it gets stuck. And instead of using this lid, I will be using the flat one, because it will get stuck on it very nicely and the proper dum I can give to my biryani. Now you can press it well and fix it nicely from the top. Yeah. Can you see? I have sealed it well from all over the corner. Now again I am going to put on the burner. Put on my burner. And I am going to keep it on low flame and cook it for another 35 minutes. So please look at the clock. 35 minutes or 30 minutes is very, very important. Now my 30 minutes are over and I'm going to put off the flame and I'm going to open the dum. I have opened the dum and the biryani is ready. Let us see how the texture is. Oh, well, that looks yummy. So let's start plating it.